What up, everyone? Zonabar here, coming at you with another video. Today, we're going to talk about business, my man. Let's get down to business. Because a huge announcement was just released, and I read an article from the Esports Observer. Great website, by the way. If you guys are interested in esports news, etc., the Esports Observer, I will put the link down below. But today, guys, Tencent details its $15 billion investment plan on esports, and I thought it was a very interesting thing to talk about, as this channel is going to talk about business side of things as well, because those are things that I'm interested about. I mean, esports is definitely the industry that I want to tackle. It's directly correlated to gaming, which I'm passionate about, and I thought you guys might be interested in. Tencent is the parent company of Riot Games. So Tencent bought Riot Games a few years ago, and Tencent regroups a lot of mobile games that you must know, like Clash Royale. They have a majority of shares on Supercell. They make a lot of games. Like, a lot of popular mobile games are made by a company that is owned by Tencent. And Tencent is very into esports, and that's why they decided to buy Riot Games, because it was a way for them to tackle the North American market. And I mean, League of Legends is really big, right? So definitely a good investment, and it's keep growing. A lot of people didn't really like when Tencent buy Riot Games, because the way Tencent work is that they're not necessarily like the most passionate gamers ever. They want to make money. Like, they want to make a lot of money. So when you see Clash Royale, the way the economics work there, with like the chest and everything you have to open, you have to buy money. The whole thing is designed so you can spend money on the game, on a free game. And people were scared when Riot Games was bought. They were like, okay, what is going to happen to League of Legends? At the end of the day, nothing really happened to League of Legends itself. And today, they release on how they're going to spend in 5 years, $15 billion, which is like 100 billion yen, on esport, and just for the well-being of the industry. So it's crazy news here, crazy investment, and crazy announcements for the Chinese community and the Chinese country and its esport development. So let's just talk about what the article says, and feel free to give me your opinion in the comment down below. I would love to hear it. So the first big thing that they say, I will link the article down below, by the way. The first big thing that they say is that they're trying to spend $15 billion within 5 years to complete new leagues, to complete new tournaments, and open new association, and also open the previously announced, which I didn't know that was announced, an esport theme industrial park in the name of Yuhu Esports Park or something. It's called Yuhu for some reason. I would also put the link of this article down below. Look, you tell me esports industrial park, I'm really down for it. Why not? But everything that sounds like league, tournaments, association, it looks really nice, and it looks like they're gonna build, and that they're in the right direction to build a really nice infrastructure and a very nice ecosystem for the players, the teams, game developers, the game providers, all the stuff. This sounds very healthy for the Chinese market. The second big thing that they announce is that it says Director of Information Center of the State General Administration of Sports confirmed that Chinese sport authorities would be working closely with Tencent. So this is very rare. In the country where I'm from France. The relationship between the government and the esports organization, like the studio I used to work with, was very low. We're getting there, we're signing stuff and stuff. Like, I know that the company is working super hard. It was already working super hard when I was there like 2 years ago, but it was really hard to get in touch with the government, because esports in France 3 years ago was still considered as a gambling game. It was at the same status as poker, blackjack, and all the casino stuff. And this is not really good. But here, the government wants to work closely with Tencent to establish the 5 years to unified standards for esports in the country. How beautiful was that sentence? The Chinese sports authorities would be working closely with Tencent over the next 5 years to establish unified standards for esports in the country. Like, this is beautiful. Like, this is a beautiful sentence, and it means a lot for the esports industry. This is big news, guys. So after this, after announcing this, they just say what Tencent is about. They're among the world top 10 companies. One of the esports competitors, Alibaba, the one of the main competitors of Amazon. You guys must have heard it. Tencent acquires 85% of Finnish mobile developer Supercell in 2006 for 8.6 billion. They recently launched a 1 million prize pool league platform for its Clash Royale, which Clash Royale is not doing very well today, but I guess we're not talking about that. And then they're just talking about MOBAs like Dota 2, League of Legends, and how in China they're really popular. There's a new one called Strikes of Kings. It's funny how China is very into mobile gaming. More, they're getting really into mobile gaming, and it's very interesting to see how this is going to be developed. Like, is the future of esport in mobile? Like, are we going to play on computers in 10 years? It's really interesting to see, and how in 5 years we're going to see like the change and how much this money will impact the industry. Like, if you think 5 years ago, esports was 5 years ago, it was season two of LCS. It was not a big deal. It was growing super fast, but it was not as big of a deal as it is today. 5 years from now, 5 years from now, it's gonna be huge. And China is going full force on it, and I'm really happy about it. So guys, let me know what you think about this announcement. I'm sure you're happy about it. And let me know what you think of those type of video. I really want to talk about business with you. I think that you guys, we are young, and we have an opportunity. We have an opportunity to work in those growing industry, because they're gonna need people to work. They're gonna need people with knowledge, and I feel that we can learn things together. Like, I could pull up news, I can pull up announcements, and just give my opinion about it and have a conversation with you over on my Twitter at Zonobra, or on the comment section down below. I'm really interested about this. Like, this is really interesting to me. I feel like China is gonna become huge. I actually want to travel to China, maybe like next year or in 2 years, just to see how the esports works. I also want to go to South Korea. Those are my bucket list travel destination there, just to get to know the industry in the other side of the world. So let me know what you guys think. I would love to hear your opinion about this. What do you guys think of what do you guys think of Tencent, like as a company? What is your opinion about their acquisition of League of Legends and like right? Games basically, and yeah, so this is it for this video, guys. I hope you like it. If you did, please share it with one of your friends that like esports and gaming. Don't forget to follow me on all social media. I will see you for the next video. Peace.